Dear students, today we will start our topic on internet addressing. First of all, we should understand that why we need internet addresses. Before starting internet addressing, let's have an example with humans when they want to communicate with each another. Each human has a name, and whenever one person wants to communicate with another person, that name is called and then the conversation started. However, in humans, we have ambiguities in names as well. So, for example, same name can be shared by multiple humans in the world or even in one region. For example, there could be a name like Khalid Walid, and that name could be shared by multiple persons. However, when we want to give names to computers, it is mandatory that we assign very unique names to each computer so that there are no ambiguities when computers are going to interact with each another, because computers are not intelligent enough like humans that they could understand that which Khalid Walid at the moment they are talking about to start the conversation. So each computer will have its own identity, and such kind of unique address is known as IP, and that IP is basically a short form of internet protocol. So how these short IPs are assigned to computers, we will learn in this module. So first of all, originally we assigned 32 bits to name the computers. So this means you have learned in one of the module that if you have 32 bits, you can assign or you can form 2^32 patterns from that 32 bits. So this means with 32 bits, we can assign internet addresses to 2^32 computers. But actually in the world, there are even more computers nowadays. So therefore, we are now moving into 128 bits in IPv6 implementations. And there is an internet cooperation for assigned names and numbers, which is called ICANN. And that organization is a non-profit organization and which assigns internet addresses to all of the computers of the world. So for example, if you want to register your computer for a specific IP, you need to talk to this ICANN organization, which can give some internet addresses to whole of your organization, and then you can choose which IP should be given to one particular computer or device. So to represent IP addresses, we use dotted decimal notation. So for example, if there is an IP address like 5.2.3.4, so we will represent each of the number into 8 bits. So you know, using the power method which we have learned in the previous modules, that 5 can be represented as 101, and you need to add 5 zeros, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 2 can be represented as 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 3 can be represented as 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 4 could be represented as 001, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this number would be representing 5.2.3.4 on the back end in computer system. So we have assigned IP addresses to each computer. However, it is still very difficult for humans to remember these numeric long codes. So to resolve such problems, there are some mnemonic symbols which can be assigned to the IP addresses of each computer. So for example, First of all, we need to understand the domain of concept of domain. So there are certain domains which are assigned to computers, like to the websites or to the servers, the IPs to the servers. For example, there is a university. So any university or educational website will be represented with a domain .edu. And then organizations will be represented with .org and government with .gov. So such domains will be easier for humans to remember. And similarly, not only these will be used, these domains. Furthermore, we will use a very specific and easy to remember full address of each server. So for example, a server which is maintaining the access of virtual university, so which is hosting the virtual university website, that has the address vu.edu.pk. Although on the backend side, it would have the whole address which we learned on the previous slides. So such kind of .edu, .org, .gov are called top level domains, TLDs. And then for representing different countries, like for Pakistan, there is .pk, for UK, there is .uk. So such kind of domains are called country level, top level domains. When you have accessed or when you have been assigned a domain for your server, then you can even make subdomains. For example, this is a domain which has been assigned or the IP address, whole IP address, vu.edu.pk. Then you can use a further subdomain OCW, which is representing Open Courseware in Virtual University. So this has been assigned furthermore to the vu.edu.pk to mean one of the particular location into your server, and all of those documents which belong to OCW will be indexed and shown at that particular place. And similarly, there could be another abc.ocw. So that abc is a particular host under the subdomain of OCW, and then there is a full IP address of your server. So whatever the name or the address is assigned to the server, when you want to access the server on the back end, then the same numeric values will be used. So for example, if you have vu.edu.pk, when one computer want to access this address, that computer will write, our user will write vu.edu.pk. However, that vu.edu.pk will be translated into the actual original numeric code, which could be 172.1.0.5, something like this. So these are done, such conversion is done using name servers. So there are certain name servers which have all of the IP addresses and all of their full numeric codes, which are easier to understand. So they have such a mapping, and these name servers, when used, these name servers use international directory, which is called domain name server. And the process of looking into the domain server or the name server is known as DNS lookup. So if we summarize today's topic, we have learned a lot about internet addressing, how the numeric codes were assigned, and then how very easier to understand addresses are assigned to the servers, and who is the authority for such assignment, which is ICANN. And then we have learned about dotted decimal notation, what are domain names, name servers, domain name servers, and DNS lookups.